the attempts of changing over the Mento in the other room to Lubuntu and not doing it good. I went back to the computer and I actually started downloading Lubuntu from lubuntu.me, and it took quite a while, so I decided not to videotape any of it until the last part so that you guys can see a little bit of it. Now I'm gonna try to use the zoom button. But I don't know if I can do it. That is so crazy. Yeah, I've only used it once and not really all that good with it, so I've got 3 minutes to do it, and then I'm going to go through the process of putting it on video and or on the USB cord, card stick, whatever, and then go back in there and try it again. I have video footage I have shown, I hope I have, and because I haven't put the video back together yet, but when I am done, I'll go in there. Like I said, this is my first time actually changing one version of Linux over to another version. I've done it 3 times so far, or this will make the 3rd time, so I wanted to, you know, make an update, let everybody know what's going on, and also let you know this is my first time going through this. I've said it before, you know, this, I call them tutorials, but it's more like a walkthrough. I'm learning as I go and making a video of it as I do it, so. Okay, so now I have the download done and I'm getting ready to show you how you get it when you already have a Linux system. Like I said, with the XFBurn, that's the best way to do it. If you go to the website now, this is the first time I've done this with just the Linux, already having Linux, so I didn't know that doing that off that you get the old ones. I wouldn't suggest using that version. I've heard way, way bad stuff from it. So I went to the website, I got the download, waited for it, and now I'm going to use the XFBurn to do it. And it's really, really simple, to be honest with you. And this is basically the gist of it. It goes to the source, which is in my external hard drive. I go to the programs, startup disk, the folder that I set up, and Lubuntu 17.10.1 desktop AMD 64 ISO, and I open it. It pops up right there, and now I just go down and hit burn. To burn. Oh, but it doesn't fit on the inserted disk. How big is it? I should probably check that. And got a picture. I've got 700 megabytes here. See if that'll work. Show me much, is it? No, it needs 969 megabytes. So I need a big one if I got one. Every single CD I've got is over, or is only 700. So that's a fault right there. But just to let everybody know, I've always got a USB cord at hand that I can use. I did not expect that. So I can just compensate for it. That I will be able to do a burn from to the flash drive though. So what I'm going to have to do is go to here, copy it. See how far I can compress it to you. Now, that just ain't gonna work. So, copy it. And we come down here to Ubuntu 17. This might actually be from my Mint. So no, we don't need that. So what I do then is I come back in here and go back down. See, those were all from a mint, and from mint, and I do not want mint. So come in here and I paste Lubuntu, and I get 969 millibytes copied onto my USB drive. And I keep a copy of it on my external hard drive just in case I need it. I know a lot of people talk about, you know, using drivers for it, but you gotta understand this is an ISO download, so you don't have to unpack it. It's good to go. Another thing that I want to check out too is, well, I was waiting for this to download, I seen some programs that were free from open source that I want to check out when it concerns booting. The whole issue of losing Windows and everything, I'm not really good with that. I don't think that's a good thing. So I believe Windows 7 completely got wiped off of my other computer, and it'd be nice if I could rescue that, but I don't know for sure if it'll work or not.